Afternoon, Andoni.
Afternoon.
It's been a really positive start to the season, but you've lost three out of your last four Premier League matches. How do you transform that? Because positive performances aren't equating to 3 points, which is ultimately a huge problem.
Yeah, I agree. I think probably you look at the stats and you analyse everything and we should have got more points. But the truth is we have the points we have, no? And right now I think probably the big mistake we've made this first part of the season, start of the season, is the game we lost against Leicester. The other results, more or less, are quite logical. You know, we won the games we had to win, some good ties, difficult games we didn't take anything from there, but probably the mistake we've made was Leicester away last game, and we have to recover this point, 3 points that we lost there, and we have to do it now against the top opposition, because now we have 3 games in a row against the Champions League teams, so we have to recover those points in the difficult way. No?
The Premier League is back after the international break. I know a lot of players go on international duty, so it's always hard for you to work with the players that are left. But what have you been able to do in the last 10 days or so with the group that you've had to try and transform the results?
Yeah, it's difficult because we've lost almost half of the team. No, normally when it's an international break, you play against a big team you think can be a good chance, because they normally lose a lot of players. But in this case, I think we've been quite similar to Arsenal, no? Because we've had also a lot of players playing with their national teams. We've tried to work with the one staying here. We've had collectively to prepare just a couple of days, no more. But at least I think availability-wise, everyone has come well. No injuries, nothing in the national team game, so I'm happy in that department.
On the theme of injuries and team news, obviously what's the latest with Tyler, who I know is back in training, and there was a question mark over Milos Kerkez. Can you just bring us up to date with the players you have available?
Yeah, I think everyone is going to be available. Yes, obviously different cases. You have the case of Tyler, that you know that he hasn't played a lot, no, in a lot of time, so probably he lacks some game time, normal, but he's doing very well, he's feeling well, good sensations, he has trained very well this break with us, and he's ready. And also Milos the same, no, he had some days out, obviously, to recover, but I think he's feeling better, and we still have to train today, but yesterday both of them trained, so I hope they can both be available.
I could sit here and talk to you about all of the positive Bournemouth stats, and then there are a number. The season has been good. You've had 117 shots so far this season, which is third in the Premier League, only behind Man City and Spurs, but yet you're in the bottom half of the table. How do you transform those statistics, those shots, that attacking nature that your side has, into goals? Because ultimately that's obviously a huge problem for you.
Yeah, I wouldn't like to lose, no, the good part of the stat you gave me, no, of the volume offensively that we are having. I think also we are arriving with numbers inside the box. We are, I think, feeling like we can score. It's true that we are not scoring enough for the amount of time we are spending in close to the opposition box and the chances, shots that we are having. Probably this is the part that can make us, no, be more efficient, win more points, and be in a better spot, no, in the standings. But we trust the players we have. I think we have good players in our offensive areas, and they have to continue doing all the things that make us play well, or at least have good chances.
Obviously your philosophy is about attack. It's about being on the front foot, high energy, win the ball high up the pitch, score goals. You're one of four Premier League sides that hasn't kept a clean sheet so far this season. Now, based on your philosophy, do you care about clean sheets? I know you'd obviously like them, but if you're taking those chances, does that fact you have not had a clean sheet bother you at all?
Yeah, I think we are defending better than we were last season. Even we are receiving less goals, you know, in the average. But it's true that we can still improve there. No, the other day against Leicester, conceded I think two chances in all the game, but they scored one, and it cost us the game. No, so there are small things, especially what the most difficult part. No, that you have to be focused 100 minutes in the Premier League. You can defend very well. You can win most of their duels against your winger, against your number nine. But if you make one big mistake, probably all your good work, no, is not so appreciated. And we have to keep this focus 100 minutes, because especially the playing against the teams that we are going to play these next weeks, you cannot give them anything, because they have more than enough, no, to create from themselves.
Obviously, up next, doesn't get much more difficult than Arsenal in the Premier League, a side that have had 64 shots in their last two Premier League matches. They're unbeaten in 12 away from home. How do you approach a game? How do you prepare a side against a team that are probably the best they've been for a number of years?
Yes, obviously, if you sometimes it's not the best not to look everything to every stat. When you face this kind of opposition, you know, you have to try to respect them, but maybe not so much, no? To try to focus on the things also that we can do to hurt them. I would also say that probably has been the team from past season where we've created less against them. Both games we played against Arsenal, I think they have been the ones where maybe the second half when we played their away, but we really haven't been the team we want to be against them. They had, especially defensively, they had very good performances against us, and it's a challenge for us. It's a challenge because probably you will not have the chances we've had past games, and you have to take them, and you have to win duels against very strong defenders, and we have to impose ourselves and show that, especially at home, if we are at our level, we can even hurt these kind of teams.
I know you've spoken about Mikel Arteta beforehand. Obviously, you come from the same region in Spain. You've known each other since you were young kids. Over the course of the last year, whilst you've been operating in the Premier League and you've lived in the UK, have you had the chance to sit down with him, to have a chat with him away from the two games?
Yeah, we normally speak normally when we have the sometimes the Premier League meetings. This season also we had the chance to play against them in the US, in LA. And we were with him and the staff talking after the game, a little bit how everything was going. And I know it's going to be a really demanding game. They prepare, obviously, their team very well. They are very good players, but especially they are very focused in the collective side of the game. And when top players are really committed to prioritize the collective, they become what they are. You know, they are candidates to everything.
Has Mikel been complimentary about your team? Have you been able to learn anything from him or take anything from him in those conversations, in those moments?
No, we don't talk too much about tactics, no? We have different teams, different goals, different ways of seeing the game. Even though some phases of the game we can do the same things, but every manager does his job, tries to prepare their team the best we can, and we don't talk too much about the other team.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Mark mentioned 12 games unbeaten, I think, for Arsenal away from home. But in the whole of 2024, they've only been behind for 13 minutes away from home. How impressive are they on the road, and how are they doing it?
Yeah, it's not only on the road. You know, they've been unbeaten all the season. Nobody has beaten them. So, and the stat you said about their away form is incredible, no? All the year, just 13 minutes behind is something incredible. But it's a team that is fighting for everything. It has been the last 2 years fighting for the Premier League, and I think they've improved this season. They are even better. They are super solid. They defend really well, starting from their high press, that is very, very good, and they have a lot of dual winners. They have a physical team, and we know it's going to be difficult for us, for everyone that faces Arsenal. But we have to try to look to our strengths. I think we can hurt them in some places, and we have to trust our players.
A lot of people think this is the year they can overtake Man City, they can finally catch them after pushing them so close. I know you're not on their training ground in their club, but from what you see when you analyse them, is there one little thing that they need to do extra or they have changed that is going to give them that edge potentially?
They will know better than me, for sure. You know, they cannot do much more. They are the numbers, the stats we are talking about. You cannot improve them a lot, you know. They are in very small margins with City last seasons. Let's see also this season. Liverpool has started very, very strong, but they are the candidates to win everything, not only the Premier League, even the European competitions. I think it's for sure a great challenge for them, but luckily we don't know what's going to happen.
As good as they are, undoubtedly are, against Leicester and Southampton, their last two games, they have had big scares and ultimately got over the line. What lessons have you taken from those two games?
I think the lesson can be like you have to go through difficult moments, for sure, because if we are talking that they had 60-something shots in two games, you know, there are moments where you feel like, oof, we are here in our box and we cannot go out from here. But if you go through these difficult moments together and you can be solid at the back, for sure you will have also your chances in the other side, because they send a lot of players forward, especially if they have not a favorable result, you know, they have to risk, because obviously they come here to win it. And I think we can exploit also those spaces, because I think we have dangerous players that can hurt anyone. We have to be at our best, obviously. We have to be at our best. But if we give our level, I think we'll have chances for sure.
And this season, I think I'm right, that you've created a lot of chances in every game, whether you've had most of the possession or less than 50% possession. Is that a change that you've seen recently, that whatever way the opposition is playing, you can still... You know, are you better suited to beating different types of opposition now than 6 months ago?
It's a difficult question. I think it depends of the need we have to push. You know, when you are behind, like the other day against Leicester, you have to probably risk more on the ball, risk more on your build-up. You will have more possession, probably less spaces to exploit. You have to be more patient. You will arrive a lot of times, probably with less clear chances. If they are pushing you, probably it's going to be opposite. You can be a lot more compact, you will be less on the ball, but probably the times you will arrive with more spaces, more clear chances. We've had a little bit of everything in the games we've played, because we've played teams against that are in the top of the league, the others that are in the second half, and we have to adapt to different scenarios. I think I'm quite happy with more or less all the performances. I would say only Liverpool has been like better than us when we've or the feeling I've had, at least. But there are things that we need to improve, because we have to be more efficient, because at the end nobody remembers, you know, the against Newcastle you were better, yes, 1 point. You know, is you need to, when you are better, you need to take the 3 points, and it's costing us right now. Yes,
I realize he can't play this weekend, but Bournemouth, Mikel Arteta did nick your captain over the summer with Neto going there. What, as we saw a lot of what he did as a goalkeeper, what sort of gap did he leave initially from his leadership point of view?
For sure, no. He has been a good addition for them, for sure, because he has the experience. He also has played in big teams. You know, he has this experience in Italy, in Spain, in big clubs, no, that has contributed in the games that he has to play. He will not be here tomorrow, at least playing, because of this rule in the Premier League. But I'm sure he's a good addition for them. Yes.
And did his departure you know, left space for a voice in the dressing room. Have you noticed one player step up particularly?
No, I think it's all the teams have to evolve, no? Especially every summer. This summer we lost Neto, Dom Solanke, Lloyd Kelly, players that were a big part of what happened, not only past season, but even the seasons before. And it's natural that other players have to assume this more responsibility, different roles, and I think it's something natural. We have very good characters, I would say, in the changing room, and obviously the players we've lost, they were important, but now other players will take their roles and will continue being important, yes.